you very much, Mr. Chairman. Very good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. So, and also, I would like to thank you very, very much to the organizer and the organizing committee for inviting me to be in this hall this afternoon. Yeah, I will not talking about how to sell wood with good market or how to sell good wood. Yeah, because I'm unable to do that. So, but here, I am just intend to share with you talking about how wood actually talk, quote unquote, yeah, or communicate to people and how to practice correctly while dealing with wood. Yeah. So, with the topic that given to me, something about augmentation of wood in building of Southeast Asia, past and present. I know this is a big task for me, but I hope I can, if I'm given the opportunity, to share with you, to discuss about the issues, as the expert stated here. Okay, when we are talking about Southeast Asia, so I'm intent to erase the political boundary. So if we stand the countries in the Southeast Asia with the political boundary, especially like my country, Malaysia, we are very small actually. Yeah? So if I erase the boundary, so I can feel that I'm also big. Yeah? So, of course, if we look, refer back to the history, yeah, before the Ice Age, if you notice that the picture over there with the light blue color that we call it Sunda, last time was we call it Sunda land, or certain people call it Lemuria. Yeah, so I think the compound, the area is very big actually. Yeah, okay. How the peoples last time after got flooded by the ice, by the water, then they going further up to the north, to the west, and to the east. Yeah, so if you notice, the Southeast Asia civilization, so they have produced a lot of culture. Yeah, so a lot of things about sailing, music, food, architecture, writing in or language, in agriculture, in the weapon, etc. Yeah. Okay. I go to the issues of discussion. In my discussion, there will be a lot of drawings. No, sorry, a lot of photos. Yeah, so makes you understand what I'm talking about. Yeah, wood is an organic material. With architecture was also certainly pioneered in wood. It provides mankind's first shelter and techniques of jointing timber were later translated into masonry and concrete. Yo, this is looking at the photo over there. You notice, if you notice, there are various types of architectural form. It means that the form of the buildings will determine the different culture, the different location, yeah. It also determine the identity of the owner or the identity of the place, yeah. Actually, the buildings talking speaks to people. Okay, ornamentation in building is something about beautification of building elements, such as post and beam, wall paneling, roof structure, staircases, etc. Those are about added value to the building's appearance. Yeah? people, they have time to create ornamentation because they are free from other difficulties. They are free from wars. Then they have no enemies. That's why they have time to create, to produce ornamentation. Yeah? So, looking at the photo down there, the house is fully decorated by woodworks. Yeah. Currently, if you have time to visit Kuala Lumpur, you can please have a look at this building. Still exists. You can see as what you see here. Okay, the kind of people who built timber buildings and its ornamentation varied enormously from culture to culture that also reflect of different times. Yeah, so we need to understand this. The practice of carpentry was awarded the greatest status in Japan as well as for Malay society. I hope in China also they do the same thing. Okay, the focus of this presentation is on the development of ornamentation of wood in building of Southeast Asia and how it communicates with the people from past to present. Yeah? Okay, when talking about beauty, for me, who really understand about building, yeah, when I ask my student about what is the meaning of aesthetic and cosmetic, for them, they really understand. Yeah? So, I need to use the analogy of women on explaining building. Yeah? Okay. So, Mr. Chairman, if you are given the opportunity to choose which one you prefer, either aesthetic or cosmetic, which one you prefer? No, looking at the photo, what is, you are given the opportunity to choose to be in the real life, which one you prefer? The real, the natural beauty or something with paste on it? Difficult to make decision. Yeah? Okay. Of course, I understand that, Mr. Chairman. Okay, so actually, it's quite common, actually. Yeah? So, because what was happened, actually, in our real life, there are a lot of false elements or false things in our daily life rather than the original one. Yeah, okay. When we are talking about aesthetic or beauty to building, okay, so at the left hand side, I call it cosmetic. At the right hand side, I call it aesthetic. Okay, why cosmetic? Because then the brown color buildings, the structure is just like the normal building. Only we paste, we want to be like a Roman building. We paste it with Roman paste. If you want it to be a Greek building, then we take the Greek paste and paste it on the building. Yeah, this is what I call it, cosmetic. Oh, the building with mosque, with the dome there. If the client want to be his office, like a mausoleum of Taj Mahal, so they can paste it over. Yeah, so. When we teach architecture, we prefer the student to follow the right hand side one. Yeah? We need to show the real material, the real structure to be shown. Yeah? Don't hire it. Okay. So after this, because I want to talk about ornamentation. Yeah, I hope. With this explanation, you can get a little what I mean. Okay, in the olden days, ornamentation was also a kind of conveying certain message in a syntax manner or addressing certain issues in relation to time, place and the owner of the building that also related to history. Okay. This is a sample. I think our fellow speakers, fellow friend from Indonesia, they are quite familiar with these photos. Yeah. Actually, this is a doors and ornamentation in Masjid Agung Demak. I went there. This is one of my research. Yeah. So actually, the message with the turtle with one body, four leg, one head, one tail. There is a meaning, yeah? Or one door, the door with the carving of fish. There is a meaning, yeah? They are telling us actually. So I classified these works, this woodwork under category of historiography. Okay. Some was also related to testament. Yeah. Some traditional Malay house. Yes, they did carve at the paneling of the wall, with certain writing, certain information about to whom the house to be given after the death of his father. Yeah. So this is also happened in the Southeast Asia community. Okay. Ornamentation, building, and woodworks also inform about the profession of the owner of the house. Yeah. Just like this house. Situated in Langkawi, yeah. So it belonged to one chef, yeah. So the architects and the craftsmen used the motif of what's that? The ingredient in the food, yeah. So become motif for the carving, yeah. Okay. So, meaning that when the guests or whoever visiting this house, then they know, whoever can read the works, then they know, they will understand what is the profession of the owner. Okay? So, this is some house and decoration works also telling the position or status of the owner of the house. Yeah, so this house also situated at Langkawi. Yeah, so by looking at the motif and woodwork, guests will understand on the position of status of the owner of the house within his community. Yeah. Okay. By looking at the gable end also. Yeah, actually, for Muslim, this is very important. Because for the house, when they perform, they intend to perform, you know, their prayer. Yeah? So they always look at the gable end. Because the gable end will inform about the orientation or the direction to the Qibla. Yeah? Okay, so most of the Malay community, they oriented their house according to this position. Okay. This is another one. There are also some photos from Indonesia. Okay. This is to determine the importance of the pillar. Yeah. In Malaysia, they call it Tiang Seri. So maybe in Jawa, they call it Sokok Guru. Yeah. So, this design or the construction of the column, yeah, you see, very intricate and very interesting. At the left hand side, below at the center, actually the one is the column of Masjid Cirebon. Yeah, below there is a masjid, the mosque of kudus. Yeah, okay. This building, I think the was already there since 500 to 600 years ago, but still remain like that. Yeah. So because it was designed to be sustained again disaster. Yeah, it's just like very interesting. I discovered very interesting. It's just like pivot joint. Yeah, when it move, the roof will move, but without damaging the superstructure. Okay, when talking about the architecture development era, so I divided into three. Yeah, one during the monarchy, during the traditional approach, then because of most of the country in Southeast Asia been colonized by Western, yeah. So I put it the colonial, and another one after independence, then I call it democracy, yeah. So there are about 6, 7, or 8 approach of architecture, yeah. So during the monarchy period, most of the architecture, they use the approach of vernacularism. Yeah? During the colonial era, so during the early stage of their period, most of the colonial, they learn from vernacular architecture, so they develop the idea of regionalism. Yeah? But during at the end or the early 20th century, so because of the development of architecture in Europe, then they brought over the idea of neoclassicism. When talk classic in architecture, we always refer to Greek and Roman. Yeah, so neoclassicism meaning that brought back the idea of Roman and Greek. Yeah, so during the end of 19th century, the start of modern movement in architecture. So a lot of architecture they use the approach of modernism. Yeah, so after that. Continue with postmodernism, revivalism, eclecticism, and regionalism. So, of course, being independent country, most of the people, they want to be identified as their own. So that's why also we are looking for architectural identity. Yeah? Okay. So, talking about the architectural ornamentation style. So, just now, you see, in the vernacularism approach, at the left side, this is a photos of palaces, eh? The Malay palaces, all different, but they are palaces, but being designed with their own culture. Separated by regional, yeah. Okay, you see at the center, left hand side, the center. This one in Sumatra. Below that also in Sumatra, Padang. But the both palaces are different. Why? Because below there, at the left hand side, below there are stages in floor levels. Meaning that when we look through the building, we notice that the building, the palace, been built during the Hinduism era. Yeah, because the hierarchy of the floor. So when they became Muslim, they built the palace all in the same floor. Yeah, okay. So when they migrated to Peninsula Malaysia, these people also built the palace, but of course the style difference. It's different, yeah. So you can find this in Seri Menanti Negeri Sembilan. So you see, Why the palace different? Because it's subject to the locality. Okay. This is also talking about vernacularism. Yeah. Further up there, mosque in Borneo. One of mosque in Borneo. At the center there in Terengganu. At the left-hand side, below there, from Sumatra. Yeah. At the right-hand side, that one, I found it in southern Thailand. Yeah. These are design of mosques, but why it has, they have different characters. Yeah. So, again, this is because of the culture, the different culture and the different region. Okay. These are colonial building. We call it colonial building, but this actually when they built this house, they study about the traditional building of Malays. Yeah, so you can see here not much decoration, but there are still decoration, but they simplify. Okay, this. At the end of 20th century, when they brought over the architects, the carpenters, the builders from India or from England, so they built their house by using masonry. Yeah, of course they also still using timber, but in very minimal. Okay, when come to the modernism approach. In the modern era, most of the modernists was rejected ornamentation. Yeah, especially for those which related to history. You know, this has become their principles. Yeah, wood was only used in building with the approach of minimalism or with the concept of less is more. Yeah, so the carpenters, the carvers have no job. Yeah, so you see the buildings without any ornamentation except very clean cut design, timber, either timber or bamboo, yeah, or other materials. So the development of a technically advanced material found for the support at the start of the 20th century with the standard bearers of the European modern movement in architecture, Gropius, Mies van der Rohe, and Le Corbusier. Yeah? These architects ultimately set the agenda for the rest of the century by proposing to build with an entirely contemporary palette of steel, glass, and concrete, more befitting the spirit of the age. Yeah? So, you look at the building with this character, then at least after this, you will understand from which era they came from. Okay, so in the developing countries of the tropics, where timber houses are still built in the traditional manner, this tradition has come under threat from the perceived advantage of modern industrial material. Throughout the long history, timber building has been separated from the rest of architecture for failing to have the same attribute as masonry buildings. But the village people, they still build the house because they really understand only this kind of house will make their life better. Okay? However, during those times, they found that most of the craftsmanship work has discontinued and had lost on the momentum of skill and the philosophy of the works. Ornamentation has produced in a very simplistic manner with the approach of imitation, reviving and eclectic rather than developing the ideas. Yeah? The follower of postmodernists claim that the modernist has destroyed history and craftsmanship work, who also criticized that they work as silent and dead. Yeah? So therefore, they encourage using bad ornamentation and the value of history in building. But because of the craftsmen work had been stopped for a while, they don't have a good craftsmanship. They don't have good craftsmen. So what they did was they just imitate, copy from the past. Yeah. So another group of architects or designer, they use the approach of revivalism. Yeah. Because of they already missed the era of modernism, now they intend to come back with the idea of the old house. So that's why, because of they have lost the momentum, they just copy, and they all they just borrow the idea. Okay, the other group of architects or designers, they are looking different approach of architecture style. Yeah? So they are using the approach of modernistic expressionism. Yeah? This style was using the approach of simplicity in woodwork. Then building structure are exposed to show the natural beauty of the building. So at least when you dealing with them, dealing with the architects, you need to know which group that they are. Yeah, so that you can close deal with them. Yeah? Okay, the other architects or designers, they are preferring to use the approach of modernistic regionalism. Yeah, they think that the old ideas of elements, body elements, can be used back. Yeah, just like here I took photo from Indonesia. Yeah? This approach intend to insert certain value to the woodworks, but for delivering any message are still questionable. Yeah? So you see at the left hand side again, actually I don't know whether you are realized or not. Actually that building is a Buddhist temple in Taiping, in Perak. Yeah? It's a Buddhist temple. They use timber. Yeah? But look like with the context of locality. Okay, the final say, in the current approach of development with the global force on green issues, wood is bagged as organic material, but only been used as part of decoration elements rather than the main building components. It was because of due to demands of development, especially to large building, which governed by the requirement of safety. Yeah, it is happened now in Malaysia. Yeah, so because of our government still. Still not prepared yet to review our uniform building bylaw. Yeah? Because in our current uniform building bylaw, still doesn't encourage the architects to use timber as a permanent structure. So that's why another constraint for us actually to use timber. So that's why what we only can use just for shading device or internal decoration works. However, to certain countries like US, Australia, and Scandinavia, and etc., wood as superstructure are widely used with very contemporary technologies such as glue-laminated beam, portal frame, and lamella frame, etc. Ornamentation of wood is no longer conveying message of the owner, but of the technology which part of the spirit of the time. So, who involved in wood industry? What do you think about this approach? It's marvelous, yeah? It's marvelous. They use very high technology on using the wood structure in building. Okay. Ornamentation of wood has no longer conveyed message of the owner, but of the technology which part of the spirit of time. Yeah, okay. So you see the structure very, very, to me, I'm appreciate very, very much of this structure. Yeah, it's a lot of effort, a lot of combination, the ideas between the architect and the engineer. And also the supplier and also the producer, of course. Yeah? Okay, so I think by this statement, I would like to call my presentation a day, Mr. Chairman. Thank you.
Okay, thank you.